Hello. In this short video, we will take a look at how to build a workflow that can create emails from a Word document. In short, we will have a file uploaded to the SharePoint library. The workflow will create the email's body from the file, as well as attach the file to the email, and then send the email to the specified recipients. This task cannot be resolved using the out-of-the-box workflow actions that SharePoint provides, so we are going to install SharePoint workflow extensions to get the additional actions that we will need. This product extends the functionality of SharePoint Workflow Foundation and is compatible with all on-prem versions of SharePoint, starting with SharePoint 2010. The same workflow can be created for the SharePoint Workflow Manager platform as well. For this, you will need to deploy a different product, SharePoint Workflow Manager extensions for on-prem, or SharePoint Workflow extensions for Office 365 if you use SharePoint Online. For our example, we will use a lesson plan file. This file could have been uploaded by a user or generated by another workflow or by separate software. We will start with a new list workflow in the designer. You can find the actions added by SharePoint Workflow extensions in different categories. For this task, we will use the actions that are located in the email category. To work with emails, we need to connect and authorize on the mail server. For that, we use the Set SMTP Server Options action. Here, we can configure the settings for the connection. In this example, we specified the password in plain text right in the parameter of the action, but secure options are available as well. Then, we add an action called Send Email with Word Document as a body to the workflow. Here we can specify the recipient, subject, and location of the document to be sent with the email. In this case, we will use the encoded absolute URL of the item, which will be the message body. Then we add the sender, and we'll use the lesson plan, not just to generate the body of the message, but also to be attached as a file. To do that, we need to specify a new variable that will point to the file's location. We can generate this variable with an action from the array group. Create array. We specify the encoded URL and store it in the array variable. Then we specify the attachment path with this data in the send email action parameters. Lastly, we need to configure the workflow to start when a new item is created in the library. Let's publish the workflow and give it a test. For that, we will upload our lesson plan into the library. As a result, the recipient account specified in the workflow receives an email, and the body of the email is generated from our test file. There is also an attachment of that file. That was a basic example of what can be achieved with the help of additional actions provided by SharePoint Workflow Solutions, which can help you create complex and flexible workflows without coding or in-depth configuration. Feel free to download a 30-day trial of the product or contact us for a personal demo session.